Good afternoon, students. Today we are going to continue our same lesson, our third lesson, laws of motion. Now we are going to discuss a very important concept in physics, that is friction. So what is friction? Simply we can say the friction is the opposing force. Okay, a friction is the opposing force, that is when a force is applied on any object, a opposite force will be takes place. So that opposite force is known as friction. Now you see the definition. A gentle force in the horizontal direction, that is a small force will be applied in the horizontal surface of the object. When it is at rest on the table, whether it is move or not, no, it is never move. Because of the gentle force, the frictional force will be balanced and it will be at rest position. Okay, so see, it is the because of the opposing force extended by the surface on the object which resists its motion. So this force is called what? Frictional force, which is always opposing the relative motion. Relative motion means where object is moving, that force is known as relative motion between an object and the surface where it is placed. Okay, if the force is applied increased, now the gentle force is increased slowly, then the object will be move, which is when compared to frictional force, the applied force is greater, so the object is now move. Now you see this diagram, you can understand the friction. Students, now you are seeing the diagram related to the frictional force. The both diagram represents the object is at top on the table, a gentle force is applied on the object, the frictional force is against the external force, so the object remains unchanged. The second diagram also the represents, now the force is applied in the right side of the object, now the frictional force act towards the left to right, now the object remains unchanged. So this is known as what? Frictional force. A key point related to the friction, you can easily understand the frictional force is always acting on the object parallel to the surface where the object is placed. Okay, the frictional force is always parallel to the surface of the object. Also, this friction is classified into two types. One is static friction and another one is kinetic friction. Now we see one by one. First we are going to discuss about static friction. It is denoted by F suffix S, that is F vector suffix S. Now in last class we discuss about the what are the forces acting on an object when it is at rest. So the two forces will be acting when an object is at rest. One is upward force, that is known as normal force, and next one downward gravitational force towards the gravity, that is mg. Now coming to static friction, when the object is at rest position, okay, now an external force is applied. Okay, now the object is slightly moving, start moving. Now the frictional force will be applied to the opposite direction of the object moving. So that type of force is known as static friction. Okay, now see the definition. The static friction is the force which opposes the initiation of motion of an object on the surface when the object is at rest. On the surface, only two forces acting on it. They are downward gravitational force and upward normal force. Therefore, the resultant of these two forces on the object is zero. Okay. Now, some external forces acting on object to parallel to the surface. Now, the rest of an object will start move. So, we have to calculate the what is the frictional force. So you just consider initially the object is at rest. Okay, and when it starts moving, it attains the maximum value, that is mu of s into n. So here the mu of s represents the coefficient of the static friction. Okay, so it is depends on the nature. Then n represents the normal force extended by the object, and substitute the value, so we get 0 greater than or equal to f of s greater than or equal to mu of s into n. So this is formula, we can easily find the what is the static friction value. Now if there is no forces acting on an object, it will be remains unchanged, there is no change in position, therefore the static friction value f of s is equal to 0. Okay, now suppose if the force is slightly applied on an object, okay, from the rest to it will be starts moving, then the value is become f of s is equal to external force, then the value, the static friction value is less than the mu of s into n. So this is very important. Then now the object is moving in slide, inclined plane, okay, when it will be attains the maximum value, that is when the object is moving in inclined plane, then it attains the maximum value. Students, see this diagram. In first diagram we are having only one mass, so easily we can move the mass with the help of the applied force. Now in the second diagram we are added another mass on the top of the mass m1. Now the force will be very hard to move the object because the weight of the object will be increased, therefore the force is required to move more. Students, next we are going to see the kinetic friction, the second type of friction. So we know kinetic friction, kinetic means movement. Okay, when an object is moving, so what about the friction? The study of friction in the moving of an object is known as kinetic friction. See the definition. If the external force acting on the object is greater than maximum static friction, which means, so we know the static friction definition. Now the object is slightly increased from rest to motion, that is known as static friction. Now the force is maximum movement of the object, then it is known as kinetic friction. So when an object slides, the surface extended a frictional force is called kinetic friction. It is denoted by f of k vector. So to move an object at constant velocity, so we must apply a force which will be equal in magnitude in opposite to the direction, that is, so the same force will be applied in the opposite side to move the object, that is known as kinetic friction. See this diagram, you may understand. Students, see this diagram. This diagram represents the kinetic friction. The force is applied from left side of the object, then the velocity will be maximum, then the kinetic friction will be moved from right side to the left side. Likewise, the another diagram also represented, the force is applied from right side to left side, okay, then the kinetic friction will be moved to left to right side. From this diagram we are going to calculate the what is the kinetic friction value. So therefore the kinetic friction is represented by f of k, which is equal to mu of k into n, where mu of k is represented the coefficient of kinetic friction and n represents the normal force. Students, this value will be equal to static friction, therefore the kinetic friction is greater than the static friction. This implies, okay, so the silent features between the static friction and kinetic friction is given in the table we see. Students, a very important 3-mark question, silent features of static and kinetic friction. So we have just comparing the static friction and kinetic friction. First point, it is opposed the starting motion. So we know static friction means the starting force is applied when an object is moving, that time the opposite force is known as static friction. So coming to kinetic friction, it is opposite the relative motion of the object with respect to the surface. Now the object is moving fast. Now the force is applied on the object. The opposing friction is known as kinetic friction. Then second point, it is independent of the surface area of the contact. So wherever we place the object, it is never depends the surface. The kinetic friction also independent of the surface area. Then third point, so mu of s depends on the nature of the material in the mutual contact. That is, the coefficient of the static friction is always depends on the nature of the material. Here the coefficient of the kinetic friction depends on the nature of the material and the temperature of the surface. So here it depends on the temperature. Okay, then fourth point, so depends on the magnitude of the applied force, which means the force is applied to move the object, then only the static friction will be takes place. Then coming to kinetic friction, it is independent of the magnitude of the applied force, because already the force is applied to move the object, then only the kinetic friction will be takes place. So it is independent of the magnitude. And last one, it can take value from 0 to mu of s into n. That is, the limit value of the static friction, value from initial, that is from 0 to maximum value. Therefore, the static friction is always greater than kinetic friction. Therefore, mu of s is greater than mu of k. Now here, it never be 0, because already the object is moving, so there will be no takes place in the rest position. Already it will be in the maximum speed, therefore it will be having the value of mu k into n. That is, the velocity will be greater than 10 meter per second, then only the kinetic friction will be takes place. Otherwise, we can say if it is a less maximum value of the static friction, when compared to static friction, the kinetic friction value is maximum. Also, the coefficient of the kinetic friction is less than the coefficient of the static friction. So these points are very important, students. So this is a very important 3-mark question. So please remember this table. Students.